The word Catholicos means the general head or general bishop. It can be considered as equivalent to universal bishop. This title and rank is much more ancient than the title patriarch in the church. In the ministry of the early church, there were only three ranks, namely the episcopos, the priests, and the deacons. By the end of the 3rd century, or by the beginning of the 4th century, certain bishops of certain important cities or provincial capitals in the Roman Empire gained preeminence than other bishops, and they came to be known as metropolitans. The ecumenical councils of the 4th century recognized the authority of these metropolitans.
By the 5th century, the bishops in the major cities like Rome, Constantinople, Alexandria, Antioch, etc., gained control over the churches in the surrounding cities. Gradually, they became the heads of each independent regional church and were called the Patriarch, which means Common Father. The same rank in the churches outside the Roman Empire was called Catholicos. There were three ancient Catholicates in the church before the 5th century. They were the Catholicate of the East, the Catholicate of Armenia, and the Catholicate of Georgia. None of these ranks and titles are the monopoly of any church. Any apostolic and national church has the authority to declare and call its head Catholicos, Pope, or Patriarch. Even though the title Catholicos had not existed in India before the 20th century, the idea behind the Catholicate or Patriarchate as the head of a national independent church was there from the early centuries, and there was a similar native position or authority in the Indian church.
According to tradition, St. Thomas is counted as the first head or the Catholicos of India. Like all other apostles, he too established churches in the province of India and set up administration for its continuity. That was the apostolic authority that existed in this country for centuries. The role and position of a Catholicos developed over the years in the history of the Malankara Church. The first stage of the apostolic ministry in the church is from the time of arrival of St. Thomas in India until the middle of the 4th century, when the authority of the church was vested in the hands of the archdeacon. The second stage is the period of the reign of the archdeacons during this time, which lasted till the 16th century.
The third stage started when the archdeacon was elevated to the position of a bishop by the community with the name Marthoma I in 1653. Since then, the head of the community was the Marthoma Metrans, and later the position was developed to Malankara Metropolitan with more recognition. When in a religious turmoil, the Patriarch of Antioch interfered and suspended the Malankara Metropolitan, demanding complete surrender. In 1912, the church consecrated the senior Metropolitan as the Catholicos and the head of the church. In 1934, through the meeting of a Malankara Association, the authority and powers of Malankara Metropolitan was entrusted to the Catholicos. Thus, both the spiritual and temporal authorities of the church was vested in one person, who is the Catholicos cum Malankara Metropolitan, and the development of the authority in that direction was completed in the church.
The historical development of Catholicate in India. Archdeacons. In India, it was St. Thomas who established the church and appointed prelates to continue the apostolic ministry in the church. It is believed that the prelates were appointed from the ancient families, namely Pagalamattam, Shankarapuri, Kalli, and Kalyankar. Gradually, the Pagalamattam family gained prominence in the ministry, and chief prelates of the community hailed from this family. During the reign of Marthoma VIII, the metropolitan of the community in the early 19th century, the Madras government once asked him for a review of the history of the Malankara Church and gave him 17 questions to answer. On the 20th of April 1812, he gave written answer to all the questions. The last question was about the position and authority of the Malangra Metropolitan in the church. In his answer, he said that from the years 335 AD to 1308, that is, till the Kunan Cross Oath, the church was ruled by the archdeacons of Paglumatim family. He also said that after coming of the Portuguese, the church had besides him six metrans and one metropolitan.
The Metran or Malangara Metropolitan of the community was the continuation of the apostolic authority in the Malangara Church. Historical evidences say that in the early times, the title of the primate of the community was archdeacon. Sometimes the title was also known as the archdeacon of the entire province of India. The native language usually referred it to as Jadhika Kartavyan. The archdeacon of the community was the unquestioned social and political leader, and he even got local soldiers under his command to protect himself and the interests of the community. The archdeacon was the unquestioned leader of the community when the Portuguese arrived in Malabar in the 16th century. The Portuguese tried to bring the archdeacon under their control. Through the Synod of Udaimperur in 1599, they tried their level best to take over, and for a short period, they did succeed in bringing the Indian archdeacon under the authority of the Roman archbishop. The community revolted against this through the Kunan Cross Oath of 1653.
The archdeacon as bishop. After the Kunan Cross Oath, the church ordained the archdeacon as a bishop with the name Marthoma I. This ordination of the archdeacon as a bishop was a very important turning point in the history of the development of the authority in the Malangara church. All the powers of the century-old archdeacon with some more spiritual authority was given to the archdeacon when he was elevated to the position of a bishop. The Marthoma Metrans continued in succession till the early 19th century with the names Marthoma I, II, etc. till the Marthoma VIII, and they ruled the church for 1653 to 1816. The spiritual as well as the administrative authority of the community were vested on the Marthoma Metrans during this period.
In 1816, Pulikottil Joseph Mar Dionysius became a bishop, and he got an approval letter known as a royal proclamation from the Travancore government to function as a metropolitan of the community. It was now that the head of the church came to be known as Malangara Metropolitan. The position of the Malangara Metropolitan in the 19th century was a growth from the position of the Marthoma Metrans. The power and authority of the Malangara Metropolitan got more recognition than the power and authority of the archdeacons and Marthoma Metrans because of some political changes in the country through the establishment of British rule.
From 1816, Mor Dionysius II, Mor Dionysius III, Mor Dionysius IV, Mor Athanasius and Mor Dionysius V were the Malangara Metropolitans in the 19th century. Among these, Mar Athanasius and Mar Dionysius V, who exercised enormous spiritual as well as temporal power inside and as outside the community. Mar Dionysius V was the Malangaran Metropolitan at the time of Synod of Mulanthuruthy, which was in 1876. During the later half of the 19th century, there occurred a split in the community because of the works of the CMS missionaries and the reforms supported by them. This invited a closer interference of the Patriarch of Antioch.
To get over the difficulties caused by the Reformation and to support Mar Dionysius V against the reformers, the Church invited the Patriarch to come over to India. The Patriarch Peter III of Antioch came here in 1875. Instead of healing the division in the community, the patriarch tried to make use of the situation to establish his authority in the church by suppressing the authority of the Malangra metropolitan. He strongly stood with Mar Dionysius and called the Synod of Mulundruthi. The patriarch presided over the synod and directed its proceedings and took some decisions justifying the actions of the patriarch in the Malangra church. After the synod, he divided the church into 7 dioceses and consecrated 6 new bishops to rule each diocese. By these actions, the patriarch was trying to reduce the authorities of the Malangra metropolitan.
After the Synod of Mulundruthi, the church became more conscious about establishing a Catholicate in the Malangara church, mainly to avoid unnecessary interference of the Patriarch of Antioch in the internal affairs of the church. The reason being, the Patriarch himself directed the Synod of Mulundruthi and tried to attain more powers through his decisions. He claimed himself as the spiritual and temporal head of the church. The Malangara church, which was in deep need of the patriarch to fight against the reformers, yielded to all the demands of the patriarch. The legal fights against the reformers ended in the final judgment of the Travancore Royal Court in 1889. The Royal Court judgment was in favor of the Patriarch and Mar Dionysius V, which was a huge benefit to both of them in various aspects. The court declared that the Patriarch may get spiritual supervisory powers over the Malangara church. However, it also declared that he would not have any temporal authority. This decision was not appealing to the Patriarch. He used all his ways and means to establish his spiritual as well as temporal authority over the church. Mar Dionysius V died in 1909 and Mar Dionysius VI became the Malangara Metropolitan.
When Mar Dionysius VI became the Malangara Metropolitan, the Patriarch demanded a registered deed from him declaring perfect allegiance to the Patriarch. Mar Dionysius strongly refused to yield to the demands of Patriarch. The Patriarch excommunicated him on 31st May 1911. This excommunication created a lot of confusions and divisions in the Malangara church. Most of the influential lay leaders and many clergy in the church supported Mar Dionysius and stood firm with him. Malangara Metropolitan was the supreme authority in the church throughout the past years, and the patriarchs were trying with all their means to exterminate that position from the church. The church clearly understood the intention of the patriarch when he excommunicated Mar Dionysius VI.
The consecration of the Catholicos. When Patriarch excommunicated Mar Dionysius VI, there were 2 patriarchs of Antioch. One was His Holiness Abdullah Patriarch, who had powers according to the legal documents known as Firman of the Turkish government, and the other was His Holiness Abded Mashiha Patriarch, who was senior at the same time inactive at Turkey since the government withdrew his Firman. His Holiness Abdullah Patriarch was the one who excommunicated the Malangara Metropolitan Mar Dionysius. The Malangara Church contacted His Holiness Abded Mashiha and invited him to Malangara. The Patriarch came and presided over the meetings of the Episcopal Synod of the Malangara Church that decided to consecrate a Catholicos. For the Malangara Church, Mar Ivanius, Metropolitan of Kandanad Diocese, was unanimously proposed to the post of Catholicos.
On 15 September 1912, at St. Mary's Church, founded by St. Thomas in Nerunam, Mar Ivanios Metropolitan was consecrated with the name Mar Basilios Paulos I. As the first Catholicos of Malangara Church, the chief celebrant of the consecration ceremony was the patriarch Mar Abdad Messiah himself. After the consecration, the patriarch issued two kalpanas declaring the importance, privileges, power and functions of the Catholicos. All the authorities and the privileges enjoyed by the patriarch in the church as its head was given to Catholicos also.
By the consecration of Catholicos, the Indian church asserted and declared its full autonomy and became a full autocephalous church, which means to have its own head. After the demise of the Catholicos Basilios Paulus I, the bishops in Malangra together with Mar Dionysius VI consecrated Mar Pilexinos of Vakatana as the second Catholicos with the name Basilios Givargis I. When he died in 1928, Mar Gregorios was elected as his successor. He was consecrated by the Indian bishops in February 13, 1929 with the title Basilios Givargis II. The patriarchal group questioned the validity of the Catholicate in law courts and litigation went up to the Supreme Court. In September 12, 1958, the Constitutional Bench of the Supreme Court of India recognized the validity of the Catholicate and unanimously declared that the Patriarch of Antioch does not have any authority over the Malangra Church and that the Indian Church is completely free under the Catholicos of the East. Without doubt, the judgment stated that all the parishes and the properties of the Malangra Church are under the authority of the Catholicos.
Moved by the final judgment of the Supreme Court of India, the Patriarchs group unanimously recommended to the Patriarch Ignatius Jakob III to accept the Catholicos as the head of the Indian Church. In December 1958, the Patriarch and the Catholicos subjected to the constitution of the Malankara Church and accepted each other by exchanging letters. The peace in the Indian Orthodox Church, which started with the mutual acceptance of the Catholicos and the Patriarch, continued without much problem till the demise of the Catholicos Givargis II in 1964. The Malangara Association, which is the representative body for the church, elected Mar Augen Timotheos as the next Catholicos. According to the constitution of the church, the Syrian patriarch, who was in friendly terms with the Malankara church, was also invited officially to participate in the consecration of the Catholicos. The Patriarch accepted the invitation of the Malankara Church and came down to India and cooperated with the Malankara Synod to consecrate the Catholicos.
In all the churches, the position of the Patriarch or the Catholicos was a development of authority in their history. In Rome, Alexandria, Antioch and Constantinople, and in the Persian Church, it achieved almost full development and recognition in the 4th century itself. Jerusalem became a patriarchate at the Council of Chalcedon in 451 AD. The Georgian and the Armenian Catholicos was also developed at the same period. The patriarchate was developed in Russian Orthodox Church between 1448 and 1589. In Romania, it was established in 1885. The Serbian Patriarchate was established in 1879. And the Bulgarian Patriarchate was established in 1883. The Patriarchate of Ethiopia was established in 1958 only. It happened in Malangara Orthodox Church in 1912. The Catholicate in India was the growth and development through centuries within the Malangara Church. Of course, the development in other churches like Persia, Antioch, Rome, and external interference has influenced the growth in different stages.
It should always be considered as a symbol of apostolic origin, authority and heritage, as well as nationality and independence of the Malangara Orthodox Church. Throughout centuries, the metropolitan heads of the Thomas Christians were known as the apostolic successors of St. Thomas, the founder of Indian Church. The Vatican Syriac Codex 22, written in 1301 at Kodungallur, refers to the Metropolitan of the Church as the Metropolitan Bishop of the See of St. Thomas and of whole Church of Christians in India. The Church always asserted that St. Thomas had its apostolic throne in India as St. Peter had it in Rome and Antioch.
We, being the children of Malangara, believe in our Lord, our Church, our history, our Catholicate. We remember the hard work and pain that our fathers went through and keep a word to follow the truth of our Lord Jesus Christ, His holy apostles, the apostolic fathers, the church fathers, our bishops and our priests until the last breath of our life.
Adishuddha Kadolikke, Adishuddha Kadolikke, Nasaranigalude Abhimanastambham, Marthomayude Simhasanapadiyambava, Nasaranigalude Abhimanastambham, മാർത്തോമായുടെ സിംഹാസനപതിയാമ്പാവ മോർബസേലിയോ